Hello, everybody. It is wonderful to see you. My name is Luke Harbur, and this is the Lharbur Show. I have my beautiful guest here, Maddy, as my guest. Maddy, how are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty well. Thank you.
Great. Glad to hear that. She is a college student as well as a barista. And numero uno, we're going to jump into our first segment of our show.
All right.
Harbur Hot Takes.
Let's do it.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Hot take numero uno. Why do you think people get a power high off of mistreating service workers?
Societal structural hierarchies and ego.
Wow, very wise. Okay, number two. What are your thoughts on open relationships? One sentence.
Okay. Can work, but communication is key.
Great, there was a comma in there and I appreciate that.
That's still one sentence.
It's still one sentence, very good. Okay, and number three, is it okay to flirt on the job?
Absolutely, I am 100% flirting all of the time.
Oh, I love it. Folks, now we are going to jump into the second segment of our show, Harbur Talk. And now she will get 9 total minutes to talk about 3 taboo topics. Matt.
Yes.
Are you ready for this?
I am ready.
Great. Let's jump right in with the topic of breaking gender norms. Why do you personally think that's a taboo topic?
Well, I don't think it should be anymore, but it is interesting that it is, just because I think people take a lot of comfort in what they know, or what they know as truths about themselves, and then apply them to the world. So I am often mistaken for a man. And it's not because I present masculine, it's literally just because I have short hair. And it's very confusing because people believe in men have short hair and women have long hair.
Okay. So in your opinion, through your experience, have you taken offense to that? Do you find that flattering? What do you think?
In the beginning of it, when I first cut off all my hair, I was a little confused, so I think I was a little offended. At this point in my life, I could not care less. I am whatever gender that helps you sleep at night.
Oh, I love that so much. And so for you then, why do you think people have difficulty to address and talk about making that kind of mistake? Why is it taboo?
I feel like, well, because you never want to offend somebody else. Like, if you are trying to be very genuine with somebody and address them with a gendered language like ours, you don't want to, like, make the wrong move because you don't want to hurt somebody.
Right.
So it gets kind of difficult when people start to break gender stereotypes or gender constructs, because then you're like, well, now I don't know how to address this person, and so I feel threatened.
Right.
So I think it's a combination of those things, of not wanting to offend somebody, and then society and our language, you know, affecting us in a way that's like, I don't know what's going on, and I'm kind of uncomfortable now.
Okay, good point. What are your thoughts on the idea of asking people's pronouns from your standpoint?
I feel like it should be more regular, and I definitely am not the best at doing it. Like, I wholeheartedly believe in it and should still do it more. Mm-hmm. Like, you meet somebody new and you should just ask them, even if you don't think anything about it.
Right.
Just ask.
Good point. It can be as simple as asking.
Exactly.
For any taboo topic when you think about it.
Right. It's just a communication barrier, which is why I like to relate it to a language one, because it is woven into the fabric of our language. In order to break it, it's going to be difficult.
I love that. Thank you very much for sharing. Do you want to dive into your topic or my topic? What did we agree on?
I think we did your topic.
Okay. I would love to talk to you about why I want to talk about the taboo of options other than college.
Yes.
What do you think of that particular topic? Why is it taboo?
So as of right now, still being in college and still being a couple semesters away from a degree, I believe 100% in other avenues related or not related to college, because I think vocations are important, and I am starting to be of the opinion that having like a good skill or like a good foundation of workforce experience should come sooner rather than later. And it shouldn't depend on a college degree, because I feel right now, being a couple semesters away, that I've learned everything that I can learn from college.
Interesting.
I feel like there are limits to higher education.
Oh, I could not agree more
right?
with you.
And there are certain degrees that I don't necessarily find particularly like necessary to go into. Like if you wanted to major in English, hi, I'm majoring in English.
Hi, everyone.
I feel like that should be like a 2-year process, not a 4-year one.
So, okay, you're saying within higher education, the amount of education should depend on the particular subject.
Right, or like what you wanted to do with it. There should be like, and there are associate's degrees and bachelor's and then master's and all of that. But I feel like there should be like a distinction with what can be done within a subject. So I feel like an associate's degree in English should be able to get you a journalism job.
Very good.
Because after a while, it's just practice and talent and all of those things.
And experience.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, it's like, how many articles have you written? Where has it gotten published?
Right.
Are you reliable?
Right. But if you were trying to teach English, then maybe, especially at a college level, then I would pursue a PhD or a master's in English and understand the language and why it works the way that it does. But if you're just going into creative writing, hi, I'm going into creative writing. then I don't think it should be as long of a process.
Yeah.
However, the other end of my degree is a biology degree.
Oh.
So I'm a double major, and I do think that biology, the lowest minimum should be 4 years.
Okay, so if you've got creative writing and biology, would you be in a combined total amount of 6 years, or do you feel like with those two subjects you can combine
it? It could still be done in four.
In four.
I still think it could be done in four.
That's interesting.
And I feel like, I don't know, I feel like I should at this point have like an English background enough to set me up for like a better job than being a barista.
Sure.
While I still have to work at getting more lab experience or this or that before I find something in biology.
Pardon me, I just had to reach down for my finagle here. Great. Okay, let's dive into the last topic that you want to talk about.
So I'm inspired to ask this question a bit because of the conversation that we had before, and a conversation that you and I often have.
Yes.
Is, do we actually have to grow up?
Yeah. Okay. Why is that taboo to you? Because I know how I think it's taboo, but why is it taboo to you?
Well, because I think, again, it's a lot of societal pressures to like be this quote-unquote adult, to be able to take care of yourself and take care of business.
Yes.
But why? I'm never going to be like, I'm going to be 40 years old and I'm still going to really love tattoos and Avatar The Last Airbender.
That's a beautiful thing.
You know?
I love that.
So while I do still feel qualified for higher responsibility.
Right.
Do I really have to not be a kid?
Huh. Right. And I guess for me, one day if I have children, I want to be that really cool dad who, like, I don't want to be the nerd dad who's like, hey, kids, has like a button up and really tight khakis that should
right.
not be worn.
Oh, no, yes.
No. But I want to be able to understand and appreciate that without having childlike curiosity as
yeah.
you get older. You get dry, dude.
Yeah, you do,
like,
get dry.
That's my thing, is like, people are like, you should grow up and have responsibilities. Right. But to have the creativeness and that energy is
yeah.
priceless.
I think
it's
that's
so
what
good
it is.
For you.
Is that, I think the answer is no, for the most part, because the world should excite you no matter what the age.
Right. And despite a lot of crap going on in the world,
so much.
At the same time, without purpose and optimism, you can't fully appreciate what the world always does
right.
have to offer.
Or the people around you, or the children
right.
around you.
Right. Oh my God. It makes my heart so warm to think about when you are a little kid and adults are like usually inspiring you and helping
yeah.
you draw out that energy, right?
Right.
Why can't we have that same invitation if you're just going off creativity?
Yeah, I think that is the exact thing. Because adults should be given the invitation to be
yes.
silly and to
yes.
have fun. No, you can't be creepy. Don't be creepy.
No,
but
don't look at kids all the time. That's not what we're talking about here on the El Harbor Show.
But the invitation to be excited and to try new things and to do something just for shits and giggles, just for funsies time.
Funsies time. Mm-hmm. Classic funsies time.
Should be encouraged, I feel like, forever. I want to be 80 years old and just be doing hood rat stuff with my friends.
Oh.
For fun.
I too hope that I want to be a crazy grandpa who like has a rickshaw and like has a big old hat and there's always candy in it. And I'm just like,
perfect.
Here you go, Jimmy.
And I don't even want a real car.
Of course, my grandchild's going to be Jimmy.
I want like a weird bicycle with like...
How many wheels?
Like, well, probably three.
Like
I'll be
three.
Old.
Yeah. Right. No, that makes a lot of sense. Okay. Well, we did it.
We did it.
9 minutes taboo topics. Woo! Nice job. Are you ready for the end slate?
I'm ready for the end slate.
Okay.
Pause, play, try to be kind, and keep making a difference.
We'll see you guys soon.
Bye.
Aw. Yeah. I feel like I'm at Harbur wedding again. Except I'm not drunk out of my mind. No, I wasn't. I was kind of drunk.
I don't know what you were.
I was happy. It was great.